Fighter than Friends. This is Darth Zediban here, and I am on site at Project Mayhem. So today we are looking at the Artifex Plus statue, the Harley Quinn one. Now, you remember if you read my article last year, this is one of the many statues that I was really, really, really looking forward to. And I gotta tell you, as you're gonna see in a few moments, Kotobukiya has taken it to the next level. Because this is without a doubt one of the best statues that they've done. So this is one of the ones that's over here in stock at Project Mayhem. You can check the links in the description below to get in touch with them. We've already opened up another one, which is bam, there's it right there. Now you gotta twist it, you gotta lick it, you gotta dunk it. Okay, don't lick and dunk it. This is not that kind of show. Okay, and there it is, the Harley Quinn statue, Artifex Plus. Now you can see from the full article and all the photos over there, this is without a doubt one of Koto's one of Kotobukiya's nicest statues. Honestly, it is simply beautiful. This is everything I've expected from a Harley statue and more. I gotta tell you, compared to some of the other stuff they'll be seeing on the market right now, this one here knocks it right the hell out. So just like with that mallet there. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go in a little closer. Being a statue, there's no articulation, so we're gonna look at the aesthetics and the age factor. So coming right in over here, as you can see, pretty girl indeed. In fact, the prettiness or the beauty of the statue probably rivals something you see in the Bishujo line. So as you know, recently we saw the new 52 version of Harley Quinn, and I gotta tell you, that one was slightly underwhelming when you compare it with this. So let's just zoom in over there just a wee bit. Okay, we'll bring her closer, and yeah, so as you can see, the paint detail is immaculate. Everything from the light shading, you can see she's got some contouring going on there. Yes, yes, she does. Family show, family show. Right, so let's look at something else because you guys are getting carried away. Okay, so as far as the sculpting is concerned, you can see phenomenal detail. I'm talking about the mallet. As you can see, it looks like it's taken some damage. And everything from the little pop rivets are nicely detailed. We see some dry brush shading over there as well. Let's just try and focus a wee bit. There you go. And even if you look at the little ruffles and riffles around on her costume, can see everything finely detailed. What I was very impressed with is that the level of detail you see over here, it also cascades itself across the figure itself. For example, you see there's little folds over here. These simulate real life. So, you know, clothing, like crease lines coming over here, even under her arm. If you look under her arm, thank you. Right, so look under her arm. You can see over there as well, that also cascades to that as well. You can see it's a very glossy figure, so it sort of simulates like vinyl, you know, which is what I imagine a suit would be made of. So yes, pretty nice. Very, very nice indeed. Okay, so let's talk about something slightly different here. As you know, the Kotobukiya Artifex Plus statues all generally come with the magnetic base. You see they've done something slightly different here. What we have is this translucent plastic. It's sort of red, looks a lot like Turkish Delight. And I gotta tell you, this is one delightful figure. I wouldn't mind meeting her in a Turkish bathhouse, if you know what I mean. Anyway, yeah, now just to move, okay, coming back to the point I was making. Yeah, so the other figures in this line over here come with the magnetic base and the little magnets under the feet of there. But you see, Koto has moved away from that, and they have the pins. Now, I'm not sure if this is going to be a new thing that we're going to be seeing with all of the statues, but I got to tell you, it works pretty nicely with this one because the overall feel here, it's almost as though Harley Quinn is on one of the little diamonds that you see over here in her costume. So yes, all in all, a brilliant figure. I gotta tell you that the age factor over here is, like I said, on the next level. So read the full review and get in touch with Riza and Nash from Project Mayhem if you'd like one of these figures. Chat to you guys soon.